And now, it's time for another Dice Tower Review with Tom Vasel.
Hey folks, my name's Tom Vasel, and today we're taking a look at a game from Playroom Entertainment called Squirmish. Now, Squirmish is, well, Squirmish the card game, I guess. This is a ridiculous rumble where creatures crash and only the strangest survive. Yes, if you look at the cover here, you'll see that this is a crazy, insane matchup of fighting, and that's what this game is. This is a silly game. You don't like silly games? You probably should stop watching review now because it's only going to get sillier. Here's how the game plays. Squirmish is made up of a whole deck of cards, and in these cards you're going to have various characters. So let's take a random look at one of the characters here. This is Cupcake, who's a fierce cat. In fact, Cupcake is part of a gang, the Kitty Cat Club, which says it can't be attacked by another KKC member, a Kitty Cat Club member, and they all have the same background, so it's easy to tell. When you attack another character, this is how many hit points they have. You're going to be putting googly eyes on them until they are completely knocked out. When you attack with somebody, you'll roll a die. So an example here, I rolled a 4, so I'll do 3 damage to the person attacking. A 1 does 1 damage, a 2 to 3, 2 damage, a 4 to 5, 3 damage, and a 6, cherry on top, 3 damage, and draw a card, which I can immediately place. There's also special abilities, can't be attacked by another cat member, I already mentioned that. And when this card is attacked, draw a card. You also have a phrase at the bottom, I'll do anything for a cupcake. And if you say that phrase the very first time this card attacks, you can get +1. Basically, you can do +1 damage with the attack. So that's kind of just a silly thing that it's possible to do. Or you can +1 healing if the attack is a healing thing. So for example, here's another Kitty Cat Club member. Miss Snoogie does 1 damage on a 1, 2 damage, 2 to 5, and on a 6, 3 damage, and the attack card can't attack next turn. Jelly Jam, who's part of the Society of Slam. Ugg, who is not a member of any club. Hobble Bob, Snuggles, etc. So, how does the game work? Well, at the beginning of the game, each character is going to pick a card and take turns placing them in the middle of the table so they're adjacent to another card. Each card, you'll notice they're all facing different ways. That's because the card will face the person who owns it. That's just an easy way to tell who controls a card. On your turn, the first thing you do is attack. So let's say Pink Eye here decides to attack. So Pink Eye is going to attack Foxy Lion. So Foxy Lion here. So we roll the die. We get a 1. No effect. Pink Eye does nothing, which is too bad because damage done by this card is done to all adjacent cards. So they could have hit both players. Oh, well. So if the attack does succeed, you put some of these on. If you knock the person out, you'll take their card and put it in your victory point pile. After you do that, then you can add another card if you want to. So each player will have a hand of cards, and I might decide to put Puffo on the board now. And again, you can put them next to an adjacent card. Or you can replace a card from your hand as long as there's no damage tokens on it. Or you can move. In this game, moving simply just means switching with an adjacent card. And that's pretty much the game. The first person to get 3 knocked out cards is the winner of the game. Now, some people are going to like this because of the googly eyes, having them on here. Although we found that for some reason, these googly eyes, when you put them on the cards, they tended to stick sometimes. Not like stick to the card, but they weren't so easy to pick up, but they do look pretty funny. But the cards is the whole point of the game, right? So you're looking at these cards, and just look at the different artwork here. Stealer Grabber, Luminetti, Crazy Frank, Brainy, Squirlock. And the cards aren't pretty hard to figure out. I mean, you have, you know, Groxney here does, on a 1-4, does nothing. On a 5-6, knocks out the opponent. It's pretty powerful. And then here, if this card's attacked on a 4-6, the attacking card takes the same amount of damage. So that's pretty interesting. Here's Thugador, Excitopup, Rapscallion, Kuga, the Wee Admiral of the Sea, Potati, Ape Beard, Mr. Carrot, the Uncommon Cold, the Great Goobla Boobla, Master Pengu, Master Tongu, Squinch, Swiney, Z-Rex, Kitty Clops, Cheetalee. So you can see there's silly pictures on all of these, and also they all have completely different special abilities and things like that. Da Boyd, Mummy Frog, and so on and so forth. So these cards are the main function of the game. I like them. I like how they look. There's a whole lot of them. The game is not very long. You won't get to see all the different cards that are in any particular game. And yeah, like here, Kilgore the Conqueror. Their quote is, "The blood of mine enemies shall flood the streets of their ancestors." Does 5 damage on a 1, 6 damage on a 2 to 5, and 6. If they have 5 cards in play, knockout, otherwise 7 damage. It's crazy, but only 1 hit point, so not very hard to kill Kilgore the Conqueror. Although, when you attack him, you roll a die, and a 4 to 6, you miss. So, all kinds of interesting creatures here. Let's go to final thoughts. There's a lot of silly games that exist out there. Games where you play funny cards, and other people, they play cards back on you. Sometimes I like them, sometimes I don't. I think where my liking of the game comes in is, A, is the humor something that's repeatable, and B, is it, you know, how long is it? Like, for example, Munchkin, which has a lot of humor and that I like, takes entirely too long for me, therefore I'm not as big of a fan of it. This game, though, is fast and furious, and I like it. Now, I think it'd be hard-pressed to say this is a great game. You literally are playing cards down, rolling dice, and see what happens. And I'm not the biggest fan of the rule of saying their phrase out loud, and I know some people who will outright refuse to play the game if that's the case. You know, I'm not saying this phrase. Well, fine, you don't get 1 extra damage. But I like the artwork a lot. The artwork is actually done by the designer of the game. It has that Mad Magazine style to it. And like I said, every game you're going to see different characters and see the combinations. And you can have the coolest character out there. And if you roll 1, nothing will happen. There's crazy amounts of luck in this game. You can hit 4 damage on someone just so someone else can walk up and go boop and take that for themselves. So it actually works almost better as a 2-player game because it doesn't happen. You're just wailing on each other. But there's no great strategy when you're done. You're not like, that's what happens when I use the combination of the Boogeyman and Boots Bat. No, I just put out the cards I have and attack with them. The game, the rule book is written in a nonsensical way too, in a sense of they make jokes throughout it. They're constantly saying, why do you care about this? Do you know an insect has only 6 legs? But it's also pretty easy to learn. And this works for kids. It gives them some choices to make, lets them roll dice. It works for adults. This is a silly game. But sometimes, silly is what we need. Dice Tower Judgment, silly, but approved.